you know, come out and really college football comes down to who's going to prepare the hardest, who's the hungriest, and who's going to, you know, perform on game day and minimize the turnovers. So that's going to be critical. Once again, we play a really good football team that's hot. They're playing good football right now. They've had some really dominant wins. Quarterback, they found him. He's been really, really good. 7 touchdowns, 1 interception, a bunch of rushing yards. Really has done a great job. Combine that with the defense that's got a ton of sacks and getting after the quarterback equals a really good football team. So we'll have to prepare and have a good plan ready and come out and execute and play well in order to win.
Jeff, what is the – obviously the quarterback is big for Virginia Tech, but when you watch them from early on until now, what's the biggest difference in why they're playing so well right now?
Well, I think that the quarterback has definitely stabilized what they're doing on offense. They're going to control the ball, and it adds an extra runner to the offense that you got to account for and have a plan for. And if you don't, he'll expose you, and they've done that. And when they're doing that, they're controlling the football. I think Syracuse only ran a total of 47 plays in the last game, which minimizes possessions, which means you got to take advantage of the ones you have. Combine that with an aggressive defense that has gotten after the quarterback and got a lot of sacks equals wins. And some of their wins have been dominant wins, which means they are capable of playing at a really high level. So this is a big game for us, and we're going to need to get ready to play.
Jeff, being that Kyron and Devin Neal played together at Baylor last year, how much has Devin has been able to help and knowing maybe some things about him that, you know, you guys maybe not be able to see on film?
Well, I think we'll get to that information, you know, this week. You know, Devin's a really smart football player. He plays tough. He's always ready to play. He's prepared. You know, and I think their quarterback has done a great job. He's young. He's gotten in there and taken things over. He's been more than efficient. He's a physical runner. He's understands and values the importance of the football. So we'll have to definitely in all of our packages account for him and his ability to run and escape and get yards.
Jeff, in your experience, a game like the Pittsburgh game, it could be a major setback. What did your guys show you in their response in practice in that game Saturday to show you that they have every intention of being in this ACC title race for the duration?
Well, I really love our team. They work hard. They prepare. They want to win. It means something to them. They stick together when things are maybe not going exactly the way we want. I think, you know, it was a good moment for our guys to understand that you got to do the small things in order to win football games. It doesn't matter what you've done in the past. I think that really alerted our guys that, you know, we've got to do this each and every week and how important the one-game season mantra is. And I think they know that on any given week you can get beat if you don't play well. And I just think that identifying the issues we had, which I thought we did, you know, turning the ball over, you know, giving up a couple big plays, you know, not converting in the red zone, a lot of things happened that hurt us. And, you know, we just got to fix those and solve those. But I think our guys are more than willing to adjust and play hard and realize that every week there's a lot riding on each and every game, so you got to come ready to play and find a way to win.
Your line, offensive line, the other day, just talk about the play, especially in the first half, you know, pushing Jawari in. They were always down the field getting after it, and then you played some other guys in the second half. Were you happy with what you saw?
I think so. Our offensive line did a really good job. We wanted to establish the run and you know, get chunks of yards and get us in manageable third downs. And, you know, I thought we were very good at that. Our line was coming off the ball. They were hitting people. They were knocking people back. They were finishing at the ball. They were pushing the pile, all those things you want to do. And so they had a great time. And it was a really good performance by them. Yes, we got more guys in the game, which we're going to need to. As we get throughout the course of the season, we're going to need more and more guys to step up. So it's important to get them valuable reps in practice, but also in the games if we can. So that'll be an important component, and you know, to this point, those guys have really given us a lot of great effort. Some of them have played nicked up and with some issues, and they continue to come out and compete hard.
Jeff, two of the last three opponents you've played in Notre Dame and Pitt, their identity was have a strong defense and also have a good running game to kind of complement that. how much confidence does it give you guys knowing that you face a Virginia Tech who's maybe the schemes are different, but whose identity is kind of similar to that of Notre Dame and Duke?
Well, I think there's a lot of similarities. The one issue with this team is now, you know, this team has a viable, really good running back that's playing the quarterback position, and they can do a lot of things. So, yes, he can play quarterback. He can throw it. He can execute the offense. But he gives them that element of running the football, and he's a physical runner. This isn't just a fast athlete. This is a physical runner that you have to tackle with multiple guys. He's involved in every one of their plays as far as whether he's handing it off, faking the handoff, keeping it himself, getting on the edge with his feet. And that gives you a different dynamic. And, you know, we have to, once again, figure out ways to make them do things that maybe they don't do as much. And I think we've had success with Notre Dame and Duke in getting a lead and making them throw the ball more than they wanted. That's not always going to happen. So you can make that your formula, but it doesn't always happen. So you have to be able to adjust and find ways to you know, play when you're down, but also you know, execute the desired plan that we're trying to get. And I just think that we've worked hard to have a vast package. We've worked hard at trying to improve the passing game. We worked hard at trying to create deep shots as much as we can. But at the same time, you eliminate sacks and turnovers. And I think our defense has improved each and every game, and they've played at a high level, and we play aggressive. But you know, the last game, we really didn't give up any big plays, maybe one down the sideline on a scramble. So that was really good to see.
Just heading into this final third of the season, you've gotten yourself in position to, you know, do something special for Louisville football. Teams get in that spot, and sometimes it makes them sharper. Sometimes they can embrace that and lose focus. Do you have a feel for where this team maybe is, and how do you ensure that it gets sharper with the opportunities it's given itself?
Well, I don't think it's too complicated. We've got to ensure it by blocking everything else out other than the next game. And, looking at anything other than the next game as a team and as coaches can get you in trouble. And I've been burnt enough time. I'm sure others have as well. So it's as simple as let's improve this week and get better and try to go win this next football game. And I think, looking at whatever happens at the end is great when the season's over. But until then, for us, it's, how do we find a way to beat Virginia Tech?
Jeff, but with social media, you know, kids get on that. They see it. It's hard to kind of block that out. Do you even address all of that stuff with your kids? Because media, fans, they are going to look ahead.
Well, fortunately, we address it almost every week. We address it in the off season. We address it through fall camp. We talk about the one-game season, as much as we can. And that's really to eliminate the pressure of looking at, where are we going to be at the end of the year? Everybody wants to be at a good spot. It's just like before the game starts, you want to win the game. But don't worry about where you're going to be at the end of the game. You better figure out ways to part one play at a time to get there. But I just think you got to it's okay to look at it. It's fine. I mean, you want them to see what can happen if you do things well and if you perform at a high level, because, everyone else is going to see it. And, yes, it's – to see it on my phone, my family is, our players, their families. Things crumble real fast when you lose. So it's as simple as just trying to, go to work, understand that the preparation, the hard work, the ability to stay hungry, and demand that you get your best performance the next game is what we're trying to do. And if we can do that, then sometimes things take care of itself. And if not, we know that we've prepared as hard as we can, and we learn from it and move on to the next one.
Hey, Jeff, Jermaine Loleo had the strip sack last game, and he's flashed with a couple big plays lately. How much of a difference maker is he when he's healthy and in this kind of form on the defensive line?
Well, I think our D-line has done some really good things. The ability to play multiple guys and have different guys step up every game has been really good to see. Jermaine has been healthier. He made some good plays for us this past game, which is great to see. He works really hard. Jared Dawson came back from a knee injury. He was productive when he was in there, made some plays, pushed the pocket. We have more than those guys that we rotate in there, and Ramon and Jeff and even some others. And we rotate those guys around, and I just think that that every position is very important. You're not going to always have it. We got to continue to build it at others, but at the defensive line right now, we have some depth, and keeping them healthy will help us perform better come game day.
Jeff, the first college football playoff rankings come out on Tuesday. How important is it? How much of a boost do you get recruiting? Just to be mentioned, I mean, it's kind of like publicity you can't buy. You have to earn it, but to be there and have them talking about your program.
Well, winning definitely puts you on notice, and you know, people want to be a part of winning programs and playing big games and beat great opponents and be on the big stage. So all that is important to us. We want to continue to work our way up the ladder, figure out ways not to slip up as we go up, but knowing occasionally that will happen. But it's important that we just keep pushing through this, and I think that you know, recruiting is vital. We'll continue to do our part. Is a great place to play, and we want to try to continue to perform at the highest level we can and get the best players here that want to be a part of it.
Jeff, another defense.
Well, it's been a lot of fun to watch our defense. I thought we were pretty good from the day I got here as far as, you know, the talent we had. There were some youth at a lot of positions, guys that haven't played a whole lot, which was always a concern. It always will be. But we like what we saw. They continue to improve. It's just a matter of getting on the field and executing. So I think we had some really good pieces on the D-line that have played football and then some others that were young, and they've gelled together and played really, really well. And having the depth there has been very important at the linebacker position. There was inexperience. A lot of guys haven't played, but, you know, those guys have stepped up. They played hard. They've done a really good job. You know, TJ and Jalen are our two starters, but we rotate other guys in there, and they've all played their role, and we got to continue to build that depth. But I think that position's improving. In the secondary, you know, two solid corners, and then, you know, Storm has come in. A transfer done a really good job. A couple other backups you'll see on the field more who are continuing to improve at the safety position. We had a couple injuries early that knocked us back a little bit. Luckily, we took a couple transfers there that have played well for us. And now, you know, our other safeties, Josh and those guys, D'Angelo, are getting healthy. We're able to rotate that. So all of it ties together. I think, you know, covering guys, getting in front of guys, having a scheme that and all of our calls covers guys as much as we can within reason of the scheme, allows the defensive line and those guys just a little bit extra time to get pressure. So we just got to continue to tweak that every week, do what we do well and emphasize that. But also I do think it's important to beat their quarterback and to have some disguise, to create some confusion, to do some things they haven't seen will always be vital to success while doing the things you do very well.
Jeff, this is kind of following up one of your earlier answers, but how do you kind of balance, I guess, or your philosophy with pursuing your goal, like pursuing the ACC title game and championship, with the one game season mantra of we have to be hyper focused on this? Like, is there any, you know, kind of dessert you dangle out there, like we can, you know, get to Charlotte?
You know what, I'm not smart enough to overcomplicate it, so we try to keep it simple. And, you know, as soon as you try to overcomplicate that, your mind starts to wander and you think of a lot of different scenarios and what can and can't happen and what we need to do, what we need to avoid. I just think that's fun for parents and fans and schools, and it's great. I mean, I'm all for it. But behind closed doors, I mean, this is a competitive football game. There's a lot of great players, great coaches, great teams across the country. On any given day, anybody can win a game. As soon as you get this much distracted, it'll cause a loss. So I've been through it. We've learned the hard way. It sounds simple, but you have to just focus on the one game in hand. This is a you know, big boy football, competitive football every week. How can we beat the other team, whoever that is we're playing every week? And if you just continue to do that, hey, at the end of the year when it's over, we'll look back and hopefully like what we saw. And sometimes we look back and like, man, I wish we had a couple of these games back. We could have done this. But, you know, it's nothing more complicated than that. Yep. We took a lot from the Purdue days. You know, we were there 6 years, probably underdog in a lot of games. Quite a few of the years, we didn't start off well. We played really good football teams, really good non-conference games, 1-2, 1-2, 0-3. So if you don't keep a one-game season, you can really start to second-guess what you're doing. You can really doubt how good you are. You can doubt what you're doing. But we were able to turn the corner in most of those seasons and improve as the year went on. And, yes, when you get to the Big Ten Championship game, I think after a 1-2 start to the season, that's a really good accomplishment. So I just think, you know, you got to, you know, coach these guys every week. You got to continue to build their confidence. You got to, you know, when they take the field, while you're correcting things during the week, they got to feel like they're the best player in the country and that you're behind them and that you're going to call this thing aggressive. You're going to allow them to make plays. You're going to allow them to take risks and cut it loose. And you know what? You may lose a few because you do that. But at the same time, you may win some that you don't think you can. I just think we err on the aggressive side, but yet smart. We want our guys to play hard. While we want to work them hard and motivate them, you know, we want them to know that we're here to help them and that we want to, you know, it is a game. We want to make it as fun as we can. So we want them to enjoy coming in here, putting work in. We want them to enjoy putting in extra work in. We want them to enjoy spending extra time with us to get better if they want to, because you have to do those things in order to win. And I just think the environment we have here, our players, you know, like it, and they want to be here. They want to work hard to achieve their goals, which can then equal to our team achieving their goals.
Jeff, 4 or 5 weeks ago, you were asked about third down conversion as far as your defense. Now, after 8 games, the opponents are still under 30%. What is it about that that's been good this season? And then second follow-up on that, specifically Gilbert, that's one of his roles. That is, I think, his role. And he had a big game the other day on a couple of tackles and the interception.
Well, I think that we've done a really good job on third. Anytime you can get him in third and long or extra long situations, it helps the defense. I think the Pittsburgh game, as we look back on it, they got into very manageable third downs, third and one, third and two, third and three, third and four, and that hurt us. So, you know, creating negative plays, getting sacks, pressuring early downs is very important. And we'll continue to do that. And it's not always easy. Some teams are going to come in and hammer away, get to manageable third down, and you got to stop it. So it's not always going to happen the way you want. I do think Gilbert is in our third down package. He's athletic. He's a former defensive back. We have him at that outside linebacker position. He can read the screenplay as good as anybody. He does it in practice. He's picked us off numerous times in practice, and they read the screenplay in the game, picked that off, and that's not easy to do. He just got a good knack and feel of reading a quarterback and understanding the schemes because he's played some football in the past. So I just think they all play their role. We mix the D-line around a little bit on third downs to create maybe a few more pass rushers, and I just think continue to be aggressive, but yet multiple and confusing the quarterback, giving different looks, will always be important.
Jeff, another defensive question. You guys have only given up, I guess, 7 points in the first quarter through 8 games. What do you just attribute to that kind of a start?
Well, probably nothing too scientific there. I do think that, you know, our teams have come ready to play. So that part I'm proud. I mean, even in the loss, I thought we were ready to play. I mean, we scored the first time we touched the ball. We got a stop. We had the lead at half. So I think our guys work hard, and they have confidence when they take the field. I think our defense has confidence in themselves and the package that we're using, and they play aggressive. And I think if we can not give their offense the ball back by having turnovers early on and sustaining some drives like we did this past game and putting points on the board early, it definitely plays to our advantage. So, you know, our defense has taken advantage of it, and, you know, they've done a really good job. So it's really, you know, credit to our players. I think they have played really hard early on, and they come ready to play.
Get you an offensive question for this one. Jawar Jordan is not the biggest guy, but that first touchdown last game, takes contact, continues to go. How is he able to run so physical at that size in between the tackles?
Well, he's you know, a really talented football player. He works really hard. He's agile. He's athletic. He's very elusive. He can start and stop and on a dime very naturally, which – create confusion and put defenders on their heels. But when he has to lower his pads, he'll lower his pads. And even though he doesn't weigh a lot, he'll get low to the ground and do the best job he can. I think he's protected the football. He's done a lot of the small things correctly. But, yes, he does run hard when he has to. But if we can create space for him, that's when he's at his best. And without question, he's a big part of our offense, and he's been very unselfish doing it.